I'm deep in the remote outback of Australia on the hunt for the Murray cod.
Anything that goes past their territory, they'll eat it, even if they're not hungry.
I'm trying to find out what lies beneath the surface of this river, where I'm told Australia's largest freshwater fish could be hunting. So I've taken the plunge.
That was very interesting, very interesting. Underwater is a whole other world. You could get lost down there. This is going to really help me fish. There's so much water that I might walk past. So many places for fish to hide, even in water like this. Even big fish to hide in water like this. And it's very easy to imagine something lurking out of sight. And from what I've heard about the Murray cod and this aggressive behaviour, this territorial behaviour, in the back of my mind was this thought that at any moment something could ram me, sort of suddenly just appear from nowhere. It's a whole other world, and it's a spooky world, and it's actually quite a scary world.
With this fresh perspective, I can better focus my approach to find the Murray cod. No pool will be ignored. Time to tackle up my fly rod. Unlike the deep water in the dam, this river is shallow and full of weeds. A fly line should glide along the surface of the water, and the fly will imitate a small prey fish. These flamboyant creations have a sting in the tail. Time to gear up and head out.
This is snake country. That's why I'm not going sandals, I'm not going barefoot. I've got wading boots on there with sort of neoprene socks on, which is possibly slightly overdressed for this heat, but it's not overdressed for the snakes. The water here is really clear, which is sort of a mixed blessing. It means I can see the fish, which is great, but they can see me, which isn't so great. So I have to keep my head down below the horizon. It's very challenging. It's looking at the water, working out your tactics, how you're going to position yourself, how you're going to cast.
My first attempts don't attract any attention. The next day, I continue my search. I've already covered so much water without success, but I can't stop. I'm also getting reports that a storm is coming. Finally, some water for this parched land. But the last thing I need is to be caught in a flash flood. I venture deeper into the river system and keep searching. Suddenly, like a switch.
That's a fish. Oh, I missed it.
My fly barely hits the water before it's attacked.
Yes. Oh, it's off.
Every cast has become a target.
Ah.
I can't connect.
Ah! Off.
But I can identify the fish.
Ah! Positive ID on Murray cod.
It seems that the impending rain and promise of higher water...
Yes!
...have brought the beast out of hiding.
Oh, it's off.
Now their notorious aggression...
Oh, that's a fish. Oh, it's off.
...and territorial nature...
And it's coming after it again.
...are in full view.
He's going to go after it again. Look at this. He's going to go after it again. And it's taken it again. Oh, off. They do seem to be very aggressive. Get too close to where they live. Boom, they don't like that.
Then, in a deep, dark pool...
It's following. Yes. Yeah. Fish on.
Right. Gotcha. Gotcha, gotcha.
There we go, Murray cod. And it's a chunky fish. Amazing. That just hammered that surface lure, just came up to it and bang, aggression. These fish are all about aggression. It's when they want to feed, but it's also when you get in their face, when you get too close to where they live, they're just out and they're at you.
Judging by its size, this one has been stalking these waters for the best part of a decade.
A big one of these, I think, easily might have accounted for that story. I can look at this all day, but being a fish, I don't want it too long out of the water. I've got all sorts of things all around the world. This is one that I never thought I would see on the end of my line, and here it is. These things, I think it's part of their character. It's like, let me go, you know, that whole king of the river, and they know it. You know, what are you doing? Just leave me alone. Boom, gone. That is the Murray cod for you.
My journey started with a classic fisherman's tale of a terrifying encounter with a beast in the dark waters of the Australian outback. From everything I've seen and learned since then, I've no doubt it was a Murray cod. This is a powerful, and when they want to be, very aggressive and territorial fish.
Look at this, he's gonna go after it again. He's gonna go after it again.
And when the swimmers came too close, it triggered an explosive response. But this story is much more than that. To see a fish come back from the brink in the way the Murray cod has done is something really special. It's still got some way to go, of course, but it shows what can happen if a fish is given a fighting chance. And that is the story worth sharing.